outside and a bite at night. I'm coming to you from my lovely patio because I am hunkered down for the most part. And I'm trying to get over the awkward of making this video because it's so strange, but I've been desperate to connect with you and I've so missed us being together. And so I feel like this is the best way to do that. And as I was thinking about it, today would be service day and we would be gathering to serve people around the globe in many ways. And I thought, why don't we think about ways that we could still make today service day? We're locked down in our homes, but it doesn't mean there aren't several ways that we could love others. And I know many of you are already doing this, but I just want to encourage us to look outside ourselves, particularly today, and think about ways that we can love and care for others. Even if we're hurting and struggling, I actually think it's good for our souls to look outside ourselves. And some ways that we could do that might be bringing flowers to a neighbor or writing a handwritten note or making that phone call that you haven't wanted to make or simply making something with your hands. And I have to say, it doesn't have to be that cool, but simply the fact that you've made something for somebody and thought of them is meaningful. And so I encourage us today to think about how we can love and serve. And I think God moves in our love. He doesn't only move through our love, but He moves in us when we love. And I think this is a great opportunity for us to just come alongside other people and care for them. So let's make today service day even still. And I thought I'd also share with you just some encouragement, reiterating what reiterating some things that they have shared in the last 2 weeks as we've been studying Galatians 5. And in Galatians 5:1, it says, "It was for freedom Christ set us free. Therefore, keep standing firm and do not be subject again to the yoke of slavery." Now, in this passage, Paul is talking about the yoke of slavery as a slavery to the law. But I think Paul also is describing something that is much deeper, and it's an abiding freedom that taps into kind of setting us free from all the ugliness of our flesh. And that might be anxiety right now, or fear, or anger, different emotions that might be arising even as we're in this season, that Paul is saying Christ wants to set us free from those things. Those are actually a yoke of slavery. And Jesus enjoys giving us this freedom. It says it was for freedom Christ set us free. So He wants us to be free. He longs for us to be free. And the beautiful thing is that this freedom doesn't come from anything we do. In fact, it can't. This is only the work of the Spirit in us. And so my encouragement to you is you might be experiencing different thoughts or emotions that feel like slavery and feel like a heavy yoke, that you will bring those to God. And just again and again, how often they might arise in you and in your mind and heart, as they do for me, that's our opportunity to come to Him and just invite Him and ask Him to work, ask the Spirit to move, to bring this freedom that He's promised. And so my prayer today is that we can be set free from some of the yokes that we're carrying right now and some of the things that make us feel enslaved, and that we might find freedom even as we're hunkered down in our homes and feeling cooped up and not so free, that this freedom might permeate our lives in the right ways, the ways that God longs for. And so I also just want to mention, if there are any of you that are particularly, that are particularly hurting or struggling, I would welcome the chance to pray for you. It would be a privilege and honor for me. So please don't hesitate to reach out. And I know there might be also others of you who have very tangible needs. Maybe you've been hesitant to share those, or it feels funny. I just say we have people in our community who would love to meet those needs if we can. And so please don't also hesitate to share with me any tangible needs that you might have. That's how we be family, how we can be family with one another. So I'm going to leave you with this verse from 1 Thessalonians 5:23. It's just a kind of a benediction that Paul gives to the Thessalonian church. And this is my hope for us as well. "Now may the God of peace Himself sanctify you entirely, and may your spirit and soul and body be preserved complete, for the day of the Lord is coming. I miss you all. I can't wait till the time when we're all together again, and I hope to see you soon."